Hello, everybody. Welcome back. So, in case you're curious, let me walk you guys through my typical day. So, I'm a one-woman show with many hats. I'm a tutor. I've been a dental hygiene and dental assisting tutor for about 15, almost 16 years now. So, I help students pass their national exam. I help them through their schooling, like tutoring, teaching, mock exam questions, that kind of thing. I'm also a consultant. So I help dental hygiene business owners who are thinking about starting their own dental hygiene business, or they have started, but they need help to really make their business profitable in the first year. And that's my specialty, is helping business owners get started and be profitable in their first few years. Because we all know with any business, when you first start, you're not always profitable, you'll probably lose money, but I teach you how to be profitable. But I'm also a restorative mobile dental hygienist. So I have my own dental hygiene practice where I go to patients' homes and I clean their teeth, teeth whitening, any restorative dental hygiene service that they need. And I also have a separate office in my own home as well. So, what does somebody like me do? What's their typical day like? So, I'm gonna just walk you through what I did today. And if I bore you, I'm sorry, but this is my typical day. Okay, it's not as exciting as you might think. It's exciting when it comes to dental, but my downtime might not be very exciting to you. So, basically, I woke up this morning. So, I have a dog, I have a miniature schnauzer, and he likes to wake up early, he likes to go outside, do his business, but then he wants to eat right away. So that's what I do. So I feed him. And then I have another dog. She is a Shih Tzu and she's the shy one. She's the quiet one. She likes to sleep in. Okay. True story. But she also takes 10 minutes to eat. So, and there's a moral to my story here. So what I do is I make a coffee. I need a coffee first thing in the morning for me to function. I love my coffee. Okay. You can't take that away from me. I love it. I have a little like teaspoon of honey in my coffee and some milk. I don't have sugar. I have honey. It's a natural sweetener, so much healthier for you. Try it. Trust me, you won't even notice there's honey and not sugar in your coffee. Okay, so I make a coffee. Sometimes I make breakfast, like I'll throw in some Eggo waffles. I'll quickly fry up an egg. I'll have some yogurt, but it depends if I'm actually hungry yet. And then what I'll do is I'll feed my other dog, so my Shih Tzu, I feed her in my bedroom. I know, funny, but that's what I do because it takes her 10 minutes to eat. She eats one, like, not pebble because they're bigger than pebbles, but like one food at a time. Like she doesn't eat everything like my miniature schnauzer does. Like he will eat his whole bowl in like 2 seconds. She takes 10 minutes. So I bring my coffee over, maybe my food, and I sit with her on the bed. Yes, I sit with her on the bed. That's the only way she will eat is if somebody watches her eat. So I'll try not to make this too much longer. Okay. So that's what I do. And then by then, I've probably finished my coffee because it takes her 10 minutes. And then what I do is I sit down with my dogs. And I watch a movie or a TV show. That is something I love to do that makes me happy. So I'll sit down with them. I'll probably turn on the fire because my miniature schnauzer loves the fire. So in fact, he's sitting there right now. I will turn on the fire for him. Oh my goodness, you guys, my allergies are acting up. Sorry if you can hear me sniffling, but I turn on the fire for him. And then I watch a movie or a show. Now, I don't typically watch a whole movie, probably about half, and then halfway through, because I kind of feel like I need to like get up, move a bit, I will tidy up the kitchen. I will tidy up the kitchen, tidy up the dining room, kind of whatever needs to be tidied up for the day. So I do that while I'm still watching my show, watching my movie. I have an open concept kitchen, living room area, best thing ever. So that helps me. So I like to multitask. Okay. So then after all of that, let's say that my movie's done. Then I get started with my day. So this is my lazy, typical morning. I love it. It's my favorite. Okay. Let me tell you, I don't consider myself a morning person. I don't even consider myself a night person, really, because I like to be in bed by like 10. but I'm not a morning person either. So it takes me a little while to feel like I'm ready to start the day. So then at that point, let's just say I'm seeing patients that afternoon. So in the morning, what I'll do is I'll work on some tutoring prep. So I will go into my office and answer emails. I will sort of like update courses. I might work on a mock exam for my dental assisting students or dental hygiene students, because I do update my courses often. And we have live tutoring sessions every couple weeks as well. So I'll kind of do what I have to do for my tutoring prep. But then I'm seeing patients that afternoon. So I will then go on my laptop, which is where I keep all of my patient info, and I will go over the charts of those patients that I'm seeing today. I'll make sure that I have their, you know, charting all set up. If they're a new patient, I will enter in their new patient info because they would have filled out the new patient forms, the medical history, the dental history, the COVID pre-screening, all of that. So I put all of that in. So that way it is fresh in my mind, and then I'll plan out my travel time and sort of where I'm going that day. So as a mobile dental hygienist, I will only go to one city a day. So I'm not going to go 1 hour outside the city that way and then 2 hours outside the city the other way or something. So I go to one city per day, and I'll go up to 2 or 3 households a day, but I love seeing one household with all of the family members. So I do encourage my patients to book their families at the same time. So if they tell me that their husband wants their teeth cleaned, their 2 kids and themselves, I'll say to them, well, I can see everybody the same day. You know, you save on the mobile fee. There's one mobile fee per household, not per person. So how about I come and see everybody the same day? So that's how I make my full-time income. And I don't work 8 hours a day seeing patients. Typically, I'll be there for 3 hours or 4 hours, and then I go home. So let's just say I'm seeing one household today, which is true. I'm just seeing the one household about 45 minutes away. I'm seeing a husband and a wife. So for 2 people, I book 3 hours. That includes cleanup time and setup time. Usually I'm done early, or hey, who knows, if I like to chat or if my patient likes to chat, I'll be done 10 minutes later. Who knows? But I can just head home afterwards. And I've just made a full day's income seeing 2 people in 3 hours. This is the life, okay? Let me tell you, it is so nice. People often ask me, oh, how did you know you wanted to quit the dental office, like quit a steady paycheck to work for yourself? Like, weren't you nervous? Well, that's another podcast, you know, video for another day. Of course I was. I was terrified, but it lasted all of 2 seconds because I knew starting my own business was for me. Okay. So it's the best thing ever. You know, making a full-time income in 3 hours. Yes, please. Right. So then I'll travel home and I'll see my dogs. Oh my goodness. They're so excited when I come home. It is adorable. It doesn't matter if I've left for half an hour or left for 5 hours. They're super excited. Sorry guys, just have to blow my nose. Oh boy. Sorry guys. This is live. I have allergies today. Insane. I think they're food related, but anyway, so I'll come home, let the dogs out, play with them for a little bit. And then depending on the time of day, if it's the evening, I will feed them. If it's the afternoon, then we just sit on the couch for a little bit. Cause I like to sit after, you know, 3 hours work, but I've been in the car for probably, you know, 2 hours total. So I like to sit and kind of like stretch on the couch, if that makes sense. But then like after I do that for maybe 45 minutes, so I've probably seen a show at this point, I pretty much always have the TV on, or I'm watching a movie on my iPad or something. I like to have the noise. So after I do that, I will then take out my laptop and write my patient notes for the day. Okay. So let's just say 2 people. So patient notes, like charting notes, does take about half an hour per patient, maybe 45 minutes, depending, because I put in their treatment for that day. I update their perio charting. I will submit their treatment codes to their insurance. If it's electronically, it's a little bit quicker. If I'm sending it in the mail, then I need to send the forms electronically for the patient to sign, print off those forms. I got to get the envelope, get the stamp. You get the idea. So things don't just happen in 10 minutes. Okay. So let's just say 45 minutes per patient to take my notes, send things electronically. I don't have an assistant to do this for me. One day I will, but you know, I don't mind doing it myself now. And I just, that's just what I do for right now. But I like to do that the same day, because if I wait till the next day because I'm too tired or something, I have done that before, I forget. Like I forget kind of like what I talk to the patient about, things like that. When I'm at a patient's house, I have my Apple Watch. So if I'm updating the odontogram, then I will record things on my Apple Watch. So that's awesome. So I do play that back. But that's kind of all the recording proof per se that I have. So if I don't do my notes that same day, I forget. Okay, I do. So I really try, tired or not, if I'm spending time with, you know, like friends, family afterwards, I tell them I need to do my notes first. I need to do my chart notes before I see you because I can't do them tomorrow. I'll forget. And I'll be seeing new patients tomorrow anyway. So there's more to prep for. So that's what I do. So I'll take the notes. I will get through all of that. I do always send a message to my patients that night. And I say, how do your teeth feel? Did you have any questions after our appointment today? I do that for every single patient that evening. If it's super late, like let's say 11 p.m. by the time I've finished everything, I'm not going to message them. I'll just message them the next morning. But you get the idea. So I do follow up. And then after that, I'll probably eat something. Like if I'm going to be specific here, I'll probably eat something. And then I will likely go back to my office on the computer and work on my tutoring prep. I will be doing a podcast like this. I'll be doing a video for YouTube, updating things because you guys want to hear things, right? Like you want to know about my typical day, right? You want to know, you want me to upload more podcasts, more videos. So I do try to keep up with that. So you guys aren't, you know, waiting. I answer emails. I get a lot of emails. I answer my messages. I get a lot of messages from, you know, students who have questions or from dental hygienists who also have questions. So that is my typical day. I'll quickly mention for confirming appointments, by the way, I do that, of course, as well. Probably about a week before, then a couple days before, but for mobile appointments, I always confirm the morning of as well, because I don't want to show up and have them not be there. Or if I didn't hear from them, I'm not just going to show up and hope they remembered our appointment. You know, you just never know. So I do confirm, but all of these things take time, right? So yeah, there's 24 hours in a day, but we have to sleep. I have to sleep. And these things take time. So for setting up for my appointments, I typically do it the night before, but like chart notes and things for those patients for that day, I do that morning just so it's still kind of fresh in my mind because I have a bad memory. But you see how things can easily, like those hours of the day can easily add up. So you guys, that's my typical day. If you have any questions, let me know. And I look forward to talking to you guys in the next video.